As a software developer, I am always on the lookout for tools and techniques that will help to improve my workflow. Recently, I discovered something very exciting called Nitrous.io, and I wanted to share some of the details with you and hope that you will find it as valuable and useful as I have.
Nitrous was built to support a large set of popular frameworks right out of the box. We will begin our journey by creating an account. Here on the landing page, we'll simply devise a username, and we need our email and a password. The two-step setup requires a response from the email address that we entered. So here we just click on the link and you're ready to create your first box. A box is the name Nitrous gives to each instance you build on their service. Ideally, each box represents an independent project or set of related projects. Nitrous currently runs on Amazon's EC2 cloud network, so here you can choose in what geographic region your box will reside. Because I'm on the East Coast, I'll choose US East. Next, we give it a meaningful name. Let's call this one Gordon Freeman. Now you can choose from among these popular frameworks. This is not to say that you're limited. These most popular choices set up some predefined defaults for you. Since I'm a serial Rails developer at home with Ruby on Rails, I'm going to choose Rails here, and we click Create Box. Now pay attention here. Did you notice this Nitrous bar went down? Let me explain N2O. N2O is what powers your Nitrous account. You can purchase more on a monthly basis to support several boxes or boxes with higher resource requirements. There are numerous ways to earn more N2O also. Just connecting your GitHub account, which you may want to do anyway in order to push and pull your source code as you work on it. Other ways help promote the service on social media, and this acts as an incentive or a reward for spreading the word within your network. So this initial box consumed the bulk of our available N2O, but let's see what we just created. Here's the Nitrous interface. It's comprised of three primary elements, with the exception of the menus, of course. The File Explorer is a quick way to view and navigate the files on the system. You begin with one default directory in your home root. The editor is where files can be opened for, well, editing. It's a tabbed interface, so you can easily work on and jump between multiple files as you work. And the lower portion is the command line, TTY, of this Linux instance to which you have access. It has a globally unique identification, and as you can see, we are running GNU Linux. In the File Explorer, the hidden files are not shown in order to reduce the clutter, but this button permits access to them. You then have the convenience of the editor panel to edit these files. Here's the .ssh directory with the server keys. Any Rails developer will immediately recognize the telltale signs of Ruby gems and RVM. The familiar Linux shell can be customized if you wish. And an observant user may have noticed the Git and ZSH are also preloaded. There's a lot you get by default when you create a Nitrous box. This X allows you to open the command line area to full screen. That's really handy if you're a hardcore CLI geek. The plus opens another console window, a TTY. And they are completely independent and concurrent. Close it down now back to normal size. The menu provides access to some important functions. The help area for Nitrous is magnificent, and it continues to grow in scope and detail. I offer a big hats off to the team working on that. You can also call on some help in a chat. It looks like they're not currently available, but there's an active Stack Overflow tag that has many commonly asked questions. There's no shortage of help right at your fingertips. The other areas you can easily discover on your own. This is where you send invites to get more N2O, add public keys for SSH access to your box, access your account details. The boxes menu takes us to the dashboard where you can create more boxes or reconfigure them. Since this is a Rails box, you see we have RVM pre-installed and we're ready to run Ruby 2.0. So let's create a Rails application here quickly. This instance includes everything I used to install on my MacBook Pro in order to code Rails applications, all the latest versions. Here's our Rails app. You can see how we navigate and can edit any of the files. Notice the syntax highlighting. Like any good editor, it recognized the file type and can provide some great syntax coloring. Here's a list of the common file types. The next step in developing a Rails app is to generate some models, views, controllers. So we go back to the command line. And we'll do a generate controller here. Okay, and then here it is. The editor recognized it as Ruby code. Now let's make a view. Let's use some Linux Mojo. We want to put a view in there, so and bingo, there it is. Switching between the editor and the command line is very simple. Notice that the editor is reminding us this file has been changed and not yet saved. This is also evident by the asterisk on the tab. We can now make the editor full screen, make some changes. We use the X like we did for the command line console. I click save, and then I can close the tab. Close all the tabs. Under the menu options, you see things you'd expect of a desktop application. Notice there's also shortcut keys. I can create a new file very simply. And once it's saved, the system recognizes the file type, and it performs the syntax highlighting for me. It knows many more file types than what's on this list, too. If you feel more comfortable on the Linux command line, and you're at home with VI or Vim, there's no need to feel left out. As a matter of fact, I used Nitrous to practice my Vim skills. I was writing an article for rubysource.com. You're welcome to go look it up. And at every convenient moment I had, I could log on to my Nitrous box. Didn't matter what machine I was on, where I was in the world, and I could pick up right where I left off. When developing a website, though, you need other files that you cannot easily generate in a text editor. Images, for example. No worry. Uploading files is just a click away. Browse on your computer or drag files to here, and they'll be uploaded to your root directory. And of course, we cannot do any development without source control. Git is loaded on all Nitrous boxes by default. These areas are all resizable, by the way. Let me just add. There we go. Developing a website, though, is difficult without the ability to view it. So we can start the Rails development server. And then we use the preview function in Nitrous. The support for SSL is a brand new feature. See, we have a selection of ports to use. Our server is running on port 3000, so that's the one I'll select. And there it is, the familiar Rails default index page. Shows that our application is running. Here's the unique URL. Recognize the box name I mentioned earlier. So going to the boxes menu is where we can make changes to our boxes or create more boxes. Again, select the region, define the resources that we want. I currently don't have enough N2O to build another box. You notice the red negative. Back to my one box. Here are the details. Access to the public SSH key. I can even push it to my GitHub account with just the click of a button. This assumes I've previously connected my GitHub, which we didn't do here. But here's access to the key. Copy it to the clipboard so I can paste it. I can restart the box. I can shut it down. On the free plan, all boxes will shut down after a period of inactivity. Here's where I add public keys for access to my boxes. Again, there's excellent help documentation and to guide you through the process.
And that is an introduction to Nitrous. Thank you for watching.